Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing Miss Lucille's 8-month update. So if you want to hear how last month went, then just keep on watching. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Sabra Casey. I am a mom of two little ones. I have a 3-year-old toddler named Liam, and Miss Lucille here just turned 8 months old. On my channel, you will find mostly mommy content, as well as some cleaning, money saving, and lifestyle. Lifestyle? Yeah? And lifestyle sprinkled in there. So if that kind of stuff interests you, then make sure to hit that red subscribe button down below. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram, and I have my other social media handles down below. So up to month 8, there's not really a whole lot that went on. She weighed 20 pounds. We weighed her here at home, so she gained about a pound from the last month. She is wearing 12 and 18 month clothes. 18 month definitely is a little bit big for her, but it fits, and I'd rather be too loose than too tight. So she's really kind of outgrowing 12 month and into the 18 month. She is in size 3 diapers, and I think whenever we're done with this most recent box that we bought, that we might go ahead and move her up to the size 4. We do still do the cloth diapering. We kind of just do both. It really just depends on how caught up I am as far as laundry and stuff goes, but we do still do the cloth diapering as well as disposables. She is still sleeping in her crib. She sleeps in it a little bit better than last month. We put her down for bed around 7 o'clock at night, and then she usually wakes up around 2 or so for a feeding, and then she'll go back asleep until around 7 or so. She's on a pretty good schedule right now. I finally think I figured out her schedule, and as soon as I say that, she'll switch again. But she'll usually wake up around 7 and eat, and then she'll be up for about 2.5-3 hours or so, eat, have another nap. What are you doing, girl? And she'll sleep for, I'd say on average, about an hour, hour and a half. And then, you know, wake up and play. And then she'll go down again for another nap around lunchtime, maybe 12 or 1. And then sometimes she will have another nap, like in the late afternoon, around 4 or 5. But that one is almost always like less than a half hour. It's usually very short if she does have it. Okay, so she needed a little bit of a snack. So that last nap of the day, if she does have it, will be very short, if at all. And then, you know, we eat and then do bedtime and put her down at 7. She is sitting up a lot better than she was last month. She's still a little bit wobbly, but I definitely feel more confident like letting her just kind of sit and hang out. She is still not crawling yet, but it is so funny. She will get up, and it looks like, if you know yoga poses, it looks like downward facing dog, where she's just like up on hands and feet, like up on all fours. And I don't know, I'm starting to kind of think maybe she might skip crawling and go straight to walking, but I don't know. It's just, it's crazy because at this time, Liam was already sitting up, and like, I think he started around 7 months. Like, he was already crawling and sitting up. So it's just funny how you see with both kids, like how different they are. Breastfeeding is still going really well. We haven't had any issues. She still nurses like normal. We haven't had any nursing strikes. I haven't had any supply issues. So nothing really to report there. It's all going really well. I'm hoping to make it to a year like I did with Liam. My goal with him was 12 months, and we made it to just around 13 months. He kind of weaned himself, and I was ready. We were both ready to be done. So I'm hoping I can get to at least a year with Lucy as well. She still prefers her Wubbinub, if anything. She is not a really big pacifier baby, which I'm okay with, because Liam was obsessed with the pacifiers. She's really not a thumb sucker either. I mean, she just really likes to just chew on things. We just recently got her a Sophie the Giraffe, and I was hesitant because Liam really didn't like it, and if y'all know, those suckers are not cheap. So I finally got her one, and she loves it. So I kind of wish I had gotten it sooner, but what do you do? So yeah, she typically, if she likes anything, she likes the Wubbinubs, and we have a handful of those just scattered around the house, and that's really the only pacifier she takes. She's pretty particular and always has been about what kind of pacifier she likes. So that one she usually only takes like when she's sleeping, if at all. She has started to not really care so much for like her jumper and her Mamaroo and just all, pretty much anything that she can be sat in, she is not into it. She would much prefer to just be on the floor and just explore. And it's so funny because she's not crawling yet, but she will if you turn your back for a second, she will be across the room. So she'll roll and she'll scoot backwards, and like she figures out how to get from one side of the room to the other. So it's kind of funny. But yeah, she would much prefer to just be on the floor and just explore. She is still just a big old wiggle worm, as you could tell. And she still grabs at everything. If it's near her, she's gonna grab it. Doesn't matter what it is, she wants it. So she grabs everything. She still puts everything in her mouth. She's still gnawing and everything. We haven't really had too many bad, like, I guess, teething days. She definitely still like chews and gnaws on everything, but it hasn't been to the point where you know that they're hurting and like you can just tell that they're not getting any relief. So luckily we've had a little bit of a break on that front.
There we go.
One thing I forgot to mention, when she nurses, she gets so distracted. Like it pretty much has to be no sound, no nothing, because she will just pop off and just like look around and she gets so distracted. Don't you?
Yeah? Are you a big wiggle worm? Oh my goodness.
We have been doing a little bit of the baby-led weaning for solids, and it's still just, it makes me so nervous. I'm not there yet, so we've kind of been doing half and half, which I know is not really a thing, but we give her, you know, stuff that she can grab, like toast or... So as I was just filming that, I noticed that the camera was just going down, down, down. My tripod, the legs weren't tightened and it was just flattening out. Okay, so what I was saying with baby-led weaning, we start out with stuff that she can grab, like toast or say oranges or banana or something like that. And then once I've had about all I can take with that, then we move on to the puree. So she's kind of both, but are you done with that? Are you done with your bow? Oh my goodness. Ugh. See, Mama could not have picked a worse time of day to do this. Ugh. The lighting is just whatever. She is still completely obsessed with Liam. It is so cute. She loves him. What? What? She's definitely trying to communicate more and babble. We have been trying to start baby sign language with her. We did do that with Liam.
Yeah.
And we had a lot of success with it. And so we want to do that. So we want to do that with Lucy too. With Liam, we didn't really start doing it like super hardcore until he was probably like 9 or 10 months old. But I think they say you can start as early as 6 months. So... okay, I think that's about all she's gonna let me do. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel below. Make sure you hit that bell notification. That way you don't miss out on any other videos, especially Miss Lucy's updates. Yeah? So make sure you subscribe. I will see y'all in the next one. Bye, guys.